Hi guys, and welcome to part 3 of Learn ASP.NET MVC Core. We are going to start by checking all the web application templates that come with .NET Core framework. And since our journey is going to start from scratch, next we are going to create an empty project. After that, we are going to analyze the project structure. After you start Visual Studio, go to File, New, Project, and then go to .NET Core option, which you can find within Templates, Visual C Sharp. If you do not see the .NET Core option in here, it means that you have not installed the .NET Core framework. So for that, you need to go to microsoft.com/net/core. And then you scroll down to the second option, which says Install the .NET Core Tools Preview for Visual Studio. You simply download it and then install. Before we continue, let us first change the project name to Drink and Go. Then we press OK. So after you click OK, you are going to see three .NET Core templates for web applications. Web application template will create a .NET Core MVC application with example views and controllers. Web API will create a .NET Core application for RESTful HTTP services. And the empty template creates a project with no content in it. And this is the option that we are going to choose. After clicking OK, our project is created and you will see some more information about ASP.NET Core framework. The information you see on the screen comes from this file, project_readme.html. When it comes to project structure, it is pretty basic. On the properties, we have the launch-settings.json file where all the launch configurations can be done. The first section on this file is IIS settings, and here we can find the port in which our application is going to run if we started by using IIS Express. Another port that application will be using is the port 5000, but this port is used when we run it by using Drink and Go option. Another section is a profile section, and here we have the ASP.NET Core environment development. If we want to change this value, then we right click on the project, then we go to Properties, Debug, and then we change the development to production. We are going to explain later the difference between development and production. On the references, we see all the packages that are installed by default when the application is created, like diagnostics, IIS integration, console, etc. On www root folder, all the static files will be stored, like HTML, JavaScript, CSS, and images as well. Another important file is program.cs file, where we have our static void main method. And inside this method, we define our host configuration. Worth noting is useStartup method, which actually is an extension method. This extension method will actually define the class that will be used to start up the application, which in our case is startup.cs. Project.json is used to define the references of the project, and we are going to use it to install our Nugget packages as well. The other file is the file that we saw when the project first started, so we can remove it since we are not going to need it in the future. Startup class is as well known as the configurations class, because here we need to configure what we are going to use throughout the project. Here, for example, we can configure routing, logging, our services, etc. The last file is web.config file, which is required when you host the application in IIS or IIS Express. If you are going to use Visual Studio and delete the web.config, Visual Studio will create a new one.